We breathe a word of thanks for your service and sacrifice. And we say to you, as one people with one voice, welcome home.
Vice President Mike Pence speaking in Hawaii at that ceremony marking the arrival of what are believed to be the remains of 55 American soldiers who died in the Korean War. However, there was little coverage of the solemn event on other networks, including CNN and MSNBC. CNN showed 58 seconds of the event, while MSNBC did not show it at all. Joining me now is Fox News media analyst and media buzz host Howard Kurtz. Howard, that stands in stark contrast to the coverage right here on the Fox News channel, of course.
Which covered the whole thing. Look, I understand the temptation to cover other more controversial Trump news, but that was the wrong call, and here's why. One, you can't overstate the emotional significance of these presumed remains of American fighting soldiers coming home 65 years after the Korean War ended. And two, all of this is intricately tied to the nuclear negotiations, as was made clear by the Sarah Sanders talking about Kim Jong-un sending a letter to Trump, talking about perhaps next steps. It's a chess move in a much more complex competition. And so for both of those reasons, I think it was a mistake to either just dip into it or completely blow it off.
As far as coverage on the network newscasts, ABC World News Tonight did cover it, but for all of 24 seconds. CBS Evening News did not cover. NBC Nightly News did not cover, Howie.
Well, in the case of those broadcasts, it may be that because it was happening around the same time, it might have been logistically difficult to cover it a lot the way cable news networks can. So the test would be how much coverage is it getting today, or is it just kind of being treated as an asterisk, which, again, I think is the wrong call because of the emotional significance, but also the political significance involving these nuclear talks and whether they're going anywhere.
Yeah, it was an absolutely beautiful ceremony. I know that Bill was in for Martha last night, and to see those servicemen return back home, draped in the American flags as they were, and it was a solemn service, a beautiful, beautiful moment for this country. While the next couple of years will tell exactly who came home. While we're talking about that, Mike Pence in an interview over there was asked about the media and their coverage of this president, and he had this response, Howie.
I think there's a lot of people in the so-called mainstream media that would do well to spend a little bit more time traveling across this country and listening to the American people. As people see, when it comes to President Donald Trump, it really has been a year and a half of promises made and promises kept.
I just want to get your reaction to that, Howie.
Well, I think the vice president uses measured language to criticize the press. And look, for example, what's in the news this week? It's the latest on the Mueller investigation. It's the Paul Manafort trial, Trump tweeting about both, which does drive coverage of those events, which are not stories, obviously, favorable to the administration. I appreciate the fact that Mike Pence doesn't use some of the rhetoric that I object to, like enemy of the American people, unpatriotic, that the president has used in recent weeks. But when they talk about being the elite media being out of touch, not understanding the heartland of America, focusing too much on negative stories and not, for example, economic growth. I mean, they have a very serious point, but I do have to say that the president himself sometimes drives some of this coverage when he goes on the Twitter.
And of course, a lot of those tweets being talked about today, one was from yesterday where regarding Jeff Sessions, and the White House has responded to that. Sarah Sanders responding to those tweets and what exactly the president meant by them. Watch.
It's not an order. It's the president's opinion. The president is stating his opinion. And there's no reason he shouldn't be able to voice that opinion. The president is stating his opinion. Once again, he's stating his opinion. I think I've clarified this about 10 times now. It's the president's opinion. I don't have anything further.
And that was, of course, response to the president tweeting that Jeff Sessions should was the word he used, stop this rigged witch hunt right now.
Right. Rudy Giuliani told me in an interview yesterday, he also talked about opinion. He also said that he thinks the president was talking more about the generic Justice Department, that Sessions could not shut it down and have to be his deputy, Rod Rosenstein, because Sessions recused himself last year. The president's still angry about that, from anything having to do with the Russia investigation. When you look at that tweet, though, this is a savvy president. He named Sessions for a reason. I think the appearance is that he's pressuring his attorney general to do something. I don't think that necessarily that he will.